represent the most risk of data leakage, where tellers, loan officers, and those kind of folks can steal the data internally. Is it the printer? Is it the core processor? Is it the internet banking system? Is it, you know, is it, what is it? And what's the probability and impact on each of those assets? Okay. Third parties, where do they have a risk of data leakage? Does my asset management program need to be updated? Does the IT committee need to be talking about this? Does our network infrastructure need to be updated with a data leakage or data loss prevention infrastructure? Right, there's DLP systems that are out there that you can hook into your network infrastructure. Right, does our organizational infrastructure need to change? How about policies? Do we need a policy or procedure, any more documentational aspects around this issue? Is it a high risk issue, medium risk issue, low risk issue? If it's a high, generally you have some issue-specific policy around that issue of data leakage. Vulnerability assessment, does my program need to change because of that threat? Pen test, does it need to change because of that threat? Security awareness program, does it need to change? Do I need to tell people about this data leakage threat? Of course you do for your security awareness program, right? Your business continuity program, do you need continuity of operation additional or less because of this new threat? Incident response and audit, does audit need to be changed as a result of this threat? So again, that's kind of how you not only have an information security program, but you use the information security program. Okay. So with that, John, I'm going to look there was some questions kind of coming through. Is it possible to get a copy of the slides we used today? We'll work that through John.
Yep, we'll get them a copy.
How many people are connected to